Welcome to the topic of electronematic circuit. Today we will understand how to draw an electronematic circuit for a single acting cylinder. Let the sequence be A plus A minus. You can see it here, A plus A minus. That is forward stroke of cylinder A and return stroke of cylinder A. We will take a single acting cylinder here. We will fire it by using a 3x2 wall. This is a 3x2 wall. Now this 3x2 wall should be pneumatically operated by using solenoid, and from this end it should be spring return. So it is already spring return. Let us connect this end to the cap end of the cylinder. We'll use compressor to give connection to this from here to here. Let us name the solenoid as Y1. Okay. This is a pneumatic circuit. When solenoid Y1 gets charged, that time this wall will switch over. As the wall switches over, this position will come here, and the supply from fluid will go from here to here and from here to the cap end of the cylinder, and the cylinder will extend. When the solenoid gets discharged, that time the spring will take action. As the spring takes action, that time this wall will switch over in this direction. As the wall switches over in this direction, that time this spring will take action, and the flow of fluid will be from this end to the reservoir. Let us take a distance rule here. Let this be position A0 and position A1. We define position A0 at 00 and position A1 at 50. A1 indicates that the cylinder piston has extended, and A0 indicates that the cylinder has been retracted. Now the cylinder is in retracted position. This is the pneumatic circuit. Now we will draw electric circuit. For electric circuit, first we will take 24 volt. We will take one more, and then this will rotate by 180 degree so that this can be connected to this. We will take it, move it slightly down. Now we will take 0 volt here. One more 0 volt, rotate it by 180 degree and connect it to this. Take it down here. Now we will place a start button. Start button can be placed from here, manually operated. This is a push button. This will place here. Now we will take a relay. Relay is here. We will take a normal relay and connect this normal relay to the supply. Here. Now this relay has contacts which are normally opened or normally closed. These contacts can be seen here. This is a normally open contact. A normally open contact is the one which is open when a relay is not active, and it closes when a relay gets activated. This contact is a normally closed contact. A normally closed contact is the one which is normally closed. That is, when the relay is deactivated, the contact will be closed. This means that the contact will allow current to flow when the relay is deactivated. Here we will take normally open contact, so that when this contact is connected, that time here we will place a solenoid Y1. So when this contact is connected, that time Y1 solenoid gets charged. So first we will rename this as relay K1. We will rename this contact as K1. This is a limit switch, and we will connect this to the supply. let us put a solenoid here. So this is a solenoid that we'll put here. We'll connect it to supply. Let us name this as Y1. Now, initially the cylinder is in retracted position. It means that contact A0 is on. So we'll put A0 here. That we'll put in the form of a switch. This is say A0. Let us name it as A0, and it is a switch with a roll. This will move slightly down. Now, when you press the push button, that time the cylinder is already retracted. It means A0 is allowing the current to flow through the push button. Now this A0 will energize K1. If I connect it like this, it means K1 will get connected, energized. When K1 gets energized, that time this contact, which is a normally open contact of K1, but when it is energized, that time this contact will get closed and Y1 will get charged. But if we release the press button, that time K1 will get deactivated. That's why we will have to put a latching to relay K1. So for that latching, we'll put here K1. Let us name it as K1. And this will latch. Now what will happen? When we press the push button, A0 is initially activated because the cylinder is retracted. Current flows from here to here and K1 gets energized. When K1 gets energized, its contact 2 and contact 3, which are normally open contact, will get closed. So this contact gets closed, this contact gets closed. Now even if this push button is released, there is a flow of current from here to here and K1 relay remains energized. So when I press this push button, K1 gets energized. As K1 gets energized, its both the contacts gets closed and Y1 is energized. Now when Y1 is energized, that time this will move in this direction and current and fluid will flow from 1 to 2 and the cylinder will move forward. Let us see what happens now. If I press this and I release it. Now when this is pressed, since this was closed, K1 got charged. Since we have latched here, that's why K1 is still charged. As K1 is charged, Y1 is charged. As solenoid Y1 is charged, spring is not able to take its action. Cylinder has extended to position A1. When it has extended to position A1, that time we want relay K1 to get deactivated, because when relay K1 gets deactivated, that time solenoid Y1 will get discharged and the spring will take action. So we'll press a put a button here, button A1, or a limit switch A1, so that K1 gets discharged. We'll stop this and put normally closed switched. This is connected and this is connected to this. Let this switch be A1 and this a switch with a roll. Now what will happen? When we press this push button, this is a switch which is already open, which is allowing the current to flow. So K1 gets charged. This is a normally closed switch, so it will allow the current to flow, and K1 gets charged. When K1 gets charged, that time Y1 gets energized. When Y1 gets energized, that time fluid flows from 1 to 2 and cylinder moves forward. As the cylinder moves forward, it leaves the contact A0. As it leaves the contact A0, K1 is still energized, but as soon as the cylinder reaches the point position A1, that time this normally closed contact will get opened. When this contact gets open, that time K1 gets de-energized, deactivated. As K1 gets deactivated, Y1 gets discharged. As Y1 gets discharged, the spring will take its action and the cylinder will move backward. This we will see in the simulation. I press the start button. K1 will get activated. Again, I press the start button. K1 will get activated and solenoid Y1 get energized. When Y1 gets energized, current flows from 1 to 2 and cylinder moves forward. When it reaches A1 position, that time K1 gets deactivated. As K1 gets deactivated, Y1 gets discharged and spring takes action and the cylinder retracts. This we will see in slow motion. This is how we get the forward and reverse motion of a single acting cylinder. In our next circuit, we will see how to use delays with single acting cylinder. Thank you.